fellow scientists, welcome back.
Are you ready for a great lesson?
Good, because I am feeling so energized. I had this delicious chicken sandwich for lunch that tasted like it was bursting with energy. But where did all that energy come from? And how did it end up in my sandwich? By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to describe producers, consumers, and decomposers, and explain how they relate to the flow of energy in an ecosystem. Let's get into it. Ecosystems need a constant flow of energy to keep their inhabitants alive and thriving. Living things in an ecosystem fall into three categories, all based on how they get energy: producers, consumers, and decomposers. The energy each of those living things uses has to come from somewhere. Most ecosystems rely on energy from the sun, but as we learned in our previous lesson on photosynthesis, only some types of organisms are able to get the sun's energy directly. These are the producers. Producers are organisms that produce, or create, their own food, mainly through photosynthesis. They are also called autotrophs. Auto meaning self, and troph meaning food. So autotroph just means they make food themselves. Plants like trees, bushes, and grasses are all producers, creating their own food from carbon dioxide and water using light energy from the sun. Producers infuse their ecosystems with energy by transforming the sun's light energy into usable chemical energy. Because of this unique ability, producers play a key role in keeping an ecosystem thriving. Thinking back on my delicious sandwich, the energy in the lettuce, the onions, the slice of tomato, and the grains in the bun all came from producers. But I know a lot of that energy I got from that sandwich came from the chicken. Chickens can't photosynthesize, as far as I know, so where do they get their energy from? Because only producers are able to get their energy directly from the sun, other living things in an ecosystem have to get their energy in other ways. We call these organisms consumers. Consumers are organisms that get their energy by consuming or eating other organisms. Consumers are called heterotrophs. Hetero meaning other, and troph again meaning food. So heterotrophs get their energy from other living things. Most animals are consumers because they cannot make their own food. Instead, they rely on the energy production of producers. A rabbit, for example, takes in energy by consuming grass. The energy created by the grass through photosynthesis then passes to the rabbit, which in turn passes to any predators that eat the rabbit, such as an eagle or a fox. Animals, whether they eat plants or other animals, rely on the energy created by producers. So, producers get energy by making their own food, and consumers get energy by eating producers or other consumers. Pause the video here and determine which organisms are producers and which are consumers in your guided notes. So, that chicken got its energy by consuming plants like grass and clover, and maybe even some insects or earthworms. That energy passed to me once I ate the sandwich, making me a consumer too. When I was finished eating, I made sure to recycle what I could and threw away the rest of my trash. But what happens to the waste produced in nature? All parts of life create waste. Trees drop their leaves and animals drop other things. Just like with garbage, we don't want to leave these things just lying around. And that's where decomposers come in. Decomposers are organisms that get their energy by breaking down waste products and the remains of plants and animals that have died. As they break them down, decomposers absorb the energy from the remains and waste products, and they put nutrients back into the environment. If you've ever composted food at your house, you've seen how decomposers take food scraps and break them down into nutrient-rich soil. Like consumers, decomposers are heterotrophs since they get their energy from other organisms. Decomposers include fungi, bacteria, and some animals. Earthworms, millipedes, and dung beetles are all great examples of decomposers. They focus mainly on breaking down waste products, such as dead leaves and animal feces. They play an important role in preventing waste from building up in an ecosystem and releasing the leftover nutrients to the soil, which can then be used by other organisms. Other materials are broken down by organisms like bacteria or fungi. Fungi are actually the only organisms that can break down wood from dead trees, which is why you may often see mushrooms along the sides of fallen logs. Decomposers are critical to maintaining the health of their ecosystems. What's the last food you ate? Pause the video here and try to figure out if the energy in your food came most recently from producers, consumers, or decomposers. Let's review everything we've learned today. Organisms in an ecosystem can be classified based on how they get their energy. Producers make their own food from the sun's energy, consumers get their energy from eating plants or animals, and decomposers get their energy from breaking down waste products and the remains of dead organisms. To learn more about producers, consumers, and decomposers, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. So, the energy in the fruits, vegetables, and grains in my chicken sandwich came from producers, and the energy from the meat came from a consumer. Huh. I wonder if there's a word for things that eat both plants and animals. Well, until next time, remember, science is all around us. See you next time! Hey, hey. You know, that sandwich was great, but I really could have used some pickles.